What's going on, Salt Strong Nation? As we get into this colder weather, those water temperatures are going to drop, and a lot of us are going to be switching out of our tennis shoes and sandals that we were wearing for our summer kayak fishing to something a little bit warmer. So today I wanted to go toe-to-toe with two of my favorite kayak fishing boots for cold weather, considering we got a question in the insider community from one of our insiders asking about what would be the best boot to wear for cold weather fishing. So I wanted to make this video for him and for any others who may have that question, and these are the two boots that I will wear for kayak fishing, and I do adjust which one I'm going to wear depending on what I'm going to be doing that trip. And again, I do want to reiterate, we're not sponsored by either of these companies. These are just products that I use because I enjoy them, and I'm giving you a completely independent and unbiased review on these two. So let's go ahead and talk about which one you're going to want to choose for the condition that you're in. So I want to start off first with the one that I probably use more, which is this extra tough wheelhouse boot. Now, they do have a cheaper version of this. It's just the regular extra tough ankle. This one's a little bit more insulated. It's got a higher ankle, which I prefer for that cold weather. This runs about $110, $115, depending on where you buy it. But I really do enjoy this boot for when I know I'm not going to be getting out of the water. It's extremely comfortable. The high ankle does keep me warm. I usually wear it with a waterproof sock. I'll tuck my pants into it, but it is very well insulated. Now, where this boot does not excel is getting out of the water and starting to walk around. This nice outside shell here is very well insulated, but as you guys can see here, if you walk around, you step on some moisture, it's going to slice it wide open. It's not very durable, if I could put a word to it, and I do have another cut right over here. So I don't recommend getting out of your kayak, walking around with these. They're extremely comfortable when you're in the kayak, even if you're operating pedals or you're just sitting and you've got your feet on the bottom of your kayak floor. Very comfortable boot to wear. It does keep me very warm, but I don't recommend getting out of the kayak with it other than just, you know, regular launching and landings. If you're wading around, this is not the boot you're gonna wanna have. It's gonna get cut up, and water will get in those open cuts, and it's gonna get your feet cold, so it completely defeats the purpose of wearing one of these nice warm boots. So I highly recommend that if you're gonna be getting out of your kayak and wading around, you pick something up like this, which is the Sims Zip It Booty 2. And it runs about $100, $110, depending on where you buy it from. But this is a fantastic boot. I've used it for flats fishing for a really long time. It's made of neoprene and a really nice tough outer shell, as you guys can see here. I've walked all over oysters with this thing, and it has held up very well against them. It's not had any cuts that allow water on the inside of the boot. Again, if you do submerge your foot further where the ankle does go past, a little bit of water will get in, but it is sealed up really well when you zip up the zipper and fasten it against your leg, and not a lot of water gets in. So it does a great job of keeping cold water out. The only thing I will say about this boot is it's not something you're going to want to wear in the kayak all day, if you know you're going to just be sitting in the kayak. It's not the most comfortable. In fact, it runs a little bit small. So if you guys do buy the boot, again, they do run small, so it is more watertight. I would recommend buying maybe one size up if you feel it is too tight. Recommend trying them on before you buy them to make sure you do have the right size. With these wheelhouses, they fit pretty much true to what the rating will say that it is. I would just recommend buying the size that you would regularly buy with regular shoes. With wading boots like this one, maybe go up one size, but they are not as comfortable as the wheelhouse, but they're still pretty comfortable for a wading boot. I've had a couple other wading boots, and this one was by far the most comfortable. It's just got that great neoprene material, a very protective outer shell, and I do recommend wearing these. If you know you're going to be getting out of your kayak, walking around those creeks, which is one of my favorite things to do when the weather turns, you can find a lot of fish in really small holes, and I'll just wade around in these boots, and I absolutely love them. So it's really going to depend, again, on the type of fishing you're going to do for the boot that you're gonna wanna choose. But just to recap, if you're gonna get out of your kayak at all, I recommend having these. If you know you're just going to be sitting in your kayak all day, maybe fishing some deeper water or some higher tides, I would recommend maybe picking up one of these extra tough wheelhouses. So I hope this sheds some light on some boots that you guys might want to choose for the upcoming cold weather season. And if you guys enjoyed this video, I recommend check out some of our other tips on how to become a better inshore angler at the Salt Strong Insider Club, where you will not only become a better fisherman, but we will help you guys save up to 20% on top of the line industry gear and tackle. So I hope to see you guys in the insider community, and thanks again for watching.
Salt Strong and wet a line today.